Well, we have been talking about the Hispanic presence in our diocese and how we are to respond to it. And about, what now, almost 18, 19 years ago, I arrived in Idaho. I was 19 years old. My sister was not yet here. She stayed back in Guatemala. She's sitting at the table there. And we both were very active in the church in Guatemala. We were youth ministers back there. Believe it or not, I was a youth minister at age 15 when I was back there. And coming to Idaho Falls specifically, coming to a church, to a place, to a language I had no idea of, but coming also to a church that I knew from the womb, a church I loved, and a church and a God I loved and followed. So maybe my experience is not as harsh and difficult as some experience of somebody else. Because when I came to the U.S., I don't recall feeling an outsider or a foreigner in the church. Maybe outside the church, yes, I did. When I went to the store and I didn't know how to ask for things, and I sometimes was just ignored by the people in the store. But in the church, I never felt like that. I felt at home. And I think that's the key that we're talking here, that we feel at home in the Catholic Church. I worked in a dairy farm for a year and a half. I know Father Chuy, who is back there, worked for 10 years. So we've got something in common with Father Chuy. And knowing where our people work. I work in the potato plants too. I work in McDonald's. I work as a store clerk. I mean, I did little things here and there. And I can identify with the way our own people here work on the fields, work at the dairies, which is a very, very tiring job to do. But as we close today, to me, the call of the renewal that comes to me and to my call as a priest now, I could tell you the whole story how I become a priest, and maybe I'll just do it in a minute. But what I take from here is a renewal to be missionary, to have that zeal I used to have when I was younger. And somehow in the seminary life, I don't know, it was kind of lost. Because when I came to the U.S. and I arrived in Idaho Falls, first thing I looked for was youth group. Where is the youth group? And Father Jerry was there. And I don't know if you remember, Father, I came and asked you, Father, do you have a youth group here? It was December 1996. And Father said, well, they are not meeting during Christmas, but they will meet in January. And from that moment on, I got involved in the church. Then Father Jerry went to Nampa, and he's now still in Nampa. He's coming today. But coming to know the church in the U.S., coming to know the Hispanic reality, was a very beautiful way of encountering God in the midst of another culture and not feeling isolated. So the importance that there was already a Hispanic community in Idaho Falls that welcomed us, and we were legal, so we were not afraid of, you know, something's gonna happen to us. But I know most of my people in my parish are not. And so, I know that reality. Today, I encourage you, and especially my brother priest, because as I'm listening to all this and to Hausman's presentation, I'm saying, this is a daunting task. How am I gonna be able to do this? The only chance I have to see those Catholics that are not coming to Mass anymore, funerals, and when they come for baptisms, or maybe padrinos for confirmation, and after years and years of not being in church, they want to be part of the church. And the first thing you should tell them is, hey, you need to bring me your certificate of confirmation, you need to bring... That's perhaps not evangelizing. But it's something that we require. And the attitude and our own approach to that has to be different. Today, as I remember growing up in Guatemala and the love I have for God, what my parents taught me, what I brought here to the U.S., what I learned here, because I learned a lot in the United States, and how I was received and welcomed into the church in the community in Idaho Falls, Holy Rosary, and how I started working there. Now, maybe I was not, I don't know if I can be counted among the many, right? Perhaps my path was different, because I was already very active in the church. But there are many young people that come here that are not, and their path is different to mine. But what I learned is that I had to become part of the solution and not expect somebody else to do it for me. I remember, and I close with this, I remember the day Father John Donahue came to Idaho Falls, 1997, I believe it is, or 98, and he said, we are going to close the missions, Roberts and Mud Lake, possibly, because we don't have more priests. I was 20 years old, and I was thinking within me, what? Are we going to close churches? Why are we not doing more for vocations? And I thought, what can I do to respond to that? Next year, I entered the seminary, the following year. And through a beautiful process. Nos vamos de aquí con un reto importantísimo y hermoso, que es ser parte de la misión de la iglesia. La misión de proclamar a Jesús vivo, resucitado, que está con nosotros y que jamás nos deja solos, que nunca nos abandona. Llegar a los Estados Unidos para mí fue una experiencia diferente, dura, pero al mismo tiempo también bonita, preciosa, porque me encontré con una comunidad en Idaho Falls donde me sentí bienvenido, acogido. No me sentí un extraño en la iglesia, afuera sí, en las tiendas cuando iba y no me entendían lo que yo quería, me ignoraban porque no sabía inglés. Pero en la iglesia encontré un hogar. Y eso es lo importante de cada uno de nosotros, quizás que trabajamos en la iglesia, y sobre todo los que estamos trabajando con la comunidad hispana, hacer de que nuestra comunidad sienta que la parroquia es su hogar, que es el lugar donde pertenecen, que no son extraños, que no es un problema si me piden una llave para tener una reunión. Es su casa. Y deben sentirse con toda la confianza de que yo no tengo que tener miedo de pedir un lugar donde rendirme. En Guatemala crecí con mucho amor a Dios. Y lo encontré aquí en Estados Unidos. Aprendí inglés. Y me encontré a Dios también que habla inglés. Aprendí italiano y me encontré a Dios que habla italiano. El Señor, creo que nos encuentra cada uno de nosotros donde estemos. El reto es muy grande. A mí me reta mucho pensar que tengo que regresar allá e ir a buscar a los que no están en la iglesia. ¿Y cómo lo voy a hacer? ¿Qué voy a hacer yo solo? No estoy solo, tengo toda la comunidad. Pero es un reto grande porque el sacerdote tiene que iniciarlo. Tengo un buen grupo de la renovación, tengo cursillistas, con ellos puedo contar. Pero es un reto más allá. Me preocupa también mis hermanos de habla inglesa que no están viniendo a la iglesia. ¿Qué voy a hacer por ellos? De la convocatoria me llevo todo esto. Y me llevo esto con un sentido de misión y de renovación de mi propio ministerio sacerdotal, con el celo que entré al seminario, que de alguna manera se fue perdiendo en los 10 años de estudio, porque el enfoque fue en mí, ¿verdad? Que era muy importante. Pero que ahora hay que recuperar aún más. Lo tengo, pero creo que me hace falta ese poco más para atreverme a creer que Dios puede hacer las cosas y yo nada más tengo que quitarme el camino un poquito y ayudar a la gente a que lo pueda hacer. Dios los bendiga, gracias por asistir. Esta ha sido una otra convocatoria. Me ha alegrado mucho que muchos líderes hispanos estuvieran aquí. Y a mis hermanos sacerdotes, muchachos, tenemos una misión preciosa que hacer en nuestra diócesis. No solo con nuestra comunidad hispana, sino con toda la comunidad que servimos en la iglesia. Y es un reto que va de la mano de Dios también. Entonces, adelante,
Como decía un señor allá en Idaho Falls, para atrás ni para agarrar vuelo. Dice, para atrás ni para agarrar vuelo. Y el Señor nos llama a ser instrumentos de su amor, de su misericordia y de su perdón, donde quiera que estemos y donde quiera que lleguemos. Y eso es necesario en nuestra comunidad hispana, darle lugar para que celebre su vida de fe en nuestras parroquias. Thank you very much. God bless you y gracias por su presencia.